Hello and welcome to another video from BetaKai Systems. This video demonstrates the artificial intelligence-driven segmentation of Ritomo and the seamless interaction between Ritomo, Anza, and Meta for reverse engineering processes. We open Ritomo and we are going to start a new project. In this video, we will work with a CT scan of a shock absorber. So, we will name it accordingly and we proceed. Then we specify the input file and the image information. Finally, we select to run the project on RAM mode since this is a relatively small CT scan and we press finish. Now we see the entire shock absorber image loaded. In this project, we will focus only on the plate of the absorber. So, with the aid of the crop tool, we will isolate that region by dragging the control points of the box, and then we have this cropped image. Next, we will perform the automatic material segmentation, which is a two-step process. For the segmentation, we need to specify the material thresholds in the histogram. In this CT scan, there are clearly visible three different materials: the darker one corresponding to air, the brighter one corresponding to the metal components of the absorber, and the intermediate one for the oil within the absorber chambers. Let's focus on this region. The oil level within the outer chamber lies somewhere here. So the threshold between air and oil is placed here to capture this level. Accordingly, the threshold between metal material and oil is placed somewhere here, to capture the boundary between these two materials. Finally, we expand the seed ranges up to the thresholds. After specifying the material thresholds in the histogram, we press the seeds button and Ritomo adds seeds in the image which correspond to the classified or colored voxels. This is an intermediate segmentation step since there are still unclassified voxels. Then we press the Grow button and Ritomo now expands the seeds to obtain the final automatic segmentation result. The seed and part images are the results after applying the seeds and grow functions correspondingly. Let's rename these materials and parts accordingly. So we have the blue material for air, the red material for oil, and the yellow material for metal. Accordingly, we have the air part, the oil part, and the metal part. By enabling the volume view for the final part image, we can see that our model contains areas with oil in regions where they should not exist. These are due to the artifacts of the CT scan. If we switch to the cropped image and enable one plane view, we can see some of these artifacts in this area and in this one. So now we will see how we can correct these regions in an efficient way by using the artificial intelligence driven segmentation. We switch back to the part image. Here we can see some of the regions that need to be corrected. These corrections will be done with the aid of the manual tools, which are accessed from the item browser by right-clicking on a part item. We select to create a new part from the selected one. So now, with the aid of the box selection tool, we will select all these oil regions and create a new part from them. After this manual modification, a new modified part image is generated, where the new part can be seen. Then we merge this with the air. The next step is to fill these gaps. We will create new parts from air. This time we will switch to the outline view, where we see colored only the boundaries of the parts. From the air part, we select to create a new one, and with the aid of the polygon selection, we will select the regions that should belong to the metal part. The more accurate we are during this process, the better would be the result that we will achieve with the AI segmentation. We will perform the same correction on the other side. Now we will merge this new air part with the metal material of the absorber. Finally, we perform the rest of corrections. Using the box selection, we create a new part from the air regions. This should belong to the oil part, so we merge them with the oil part. Imagine that all these manual corrections should be repeated for each slice of the CT scan to obtain a perfect model. This is a very time-consuming process. With the aid of the artificial intelligence segmentation, this process can be automated by training an algorithm on how to correct them. The first step in this process is to create training regions. These regions should enclose all kinds of features available in the image. So by using the selection toolbar, we will select regions that we corrected manually, such as the plate regions, as well as regions that were satisfactorily segmented from the automatic segmentation. When done, we confirm with the Accept button. Then we press Train AI. Once finished, an AI data item will be generated in the item browser. The training is now done, and we will use this item for the application of AI segmentation. To apply it, we select the initial intensity image, either the original or the cropped image. In our case, we will apply it on the cropped image. So, from the context menu, we select Apply AI, choose the AI data item to be used, and we proceed. Now, the algorithm based on the training we did before will automatically segment all of the slices of the volume image at once. The AI segmentation is now finished, and a new image has been created, named Smart Image. We enable the volume view to inspect the result. We can repeat this AI process as many times as necessary and in different regions that need extra attention until the quality of the segmentation is satisfactory. By switching to the part image, we can compare it with the automatic segmentation result. In this slide, the advantages of the new AI segmentation are demonstrated through a comparison between the AI and the manual segmentation process. The plate on the left is the result of using only the manual tools to correct the artifacts, while on the right, the plate artifacts were corrected by implementing the AI process. Due to the semi-automated nature of the AI process, a high-quality result has been obtained. On the other hand, the manual segmentation result shows surface quality degradation after some time due to user fatigue. Furthermore, the AI approach led to approximately 95% time savings compared to manual segmentation correction. Moving back to Ritomo, except for the manual tools, it is possible to further improve the segmentation result using the Islands tool and the morphological filters. Islands function, which is accessible via the context menu of labeled images, creates a list containing all connected groups of voxels. From this list, groups can be filtered, and from right-click, they can be merged with surrounding, or we can create a new part. This time, we will merge these oil bubbles with the surrounding. Let me enable one plane view and switch off the volume visibility. Morphological filters are applied on each part, and they are accessed from each part's context menu. We will focus on this region where we can see small gaps in the metal part. We specify the proper plane, and by using the closing option, we can fill these gaps. The islands and morphological functions can be used either to further improve the segmentation result or for preparing training regions. Finally, except for the global AI-driven segmentation, one can perform local corrections with the aid of AI local segmentation. Now let's move on to see how to achieve a seamless interaction between Ritomo, ANZA, and Meta. Starting from ANZA, we can input the shock absorber mesh exported by Ritomo, ensuring an error-free translation of the mesh, for example, a mesh free of single and triple bounds. Then, further process it to create a CAE model. Moreover, the interaction between Anza and Ritomo is enhanced by Ritomo-specific plugins available in Anza. In this slide, we see the initial mesh as exported by Ritomo and the final mesh after mesh reconstruction and feature line editing in Anza. We open the final mesh and let's set up a fictitious durability analysis for the plate welds in Abacus Solver. Firstly, we need to specify the boundary conditions. The absorber will be fixed at its top and bottom ends and the load will be applied on the plate. For the constraints, we have the option either to generate a multipoint constraint by using an assistant or by using the general entity builders of Anza. For the bottom end, we will be using the assistant. So we enable the constraints MPC rigids many nodes function and we specify with feature area selection the slave nodes. We accept the automatically created master node and we finish. Then we enable the boundary nodes option and we select the master node of this MPC to be fixed in all degrees of freedom. For the top end, we'll be using a general entity builder or GEB. Here we have already defined one. The search area of this builder in this case is a cylinder. This GEB will select the nodes within the cylinder and will create as interface elements a rigid body element 2 which corresponds to the MPC for Abacus and as representation will create a boundary condition of type fixed. So we press apply to see the result. Here we can see that this GEB has generated an MPC collecting all nodes found within the cylinder and as representation it has created a boundary condition on the master node. The main advantage of using general entity builders is their reusability since they can be copied to another model and reapplied. Next, we create the loading of the plate. So we select the load C-load set option. Here we have already specified a set with the nodes where the load is going to be applied. So we select the set and then we specify the direction of the force that will be applied, the magnitude, and finally the distribution of this value among the set nodes. Finally, we need to specify the analysis step for Abacus. In our case, a step has been already generated along with the creation of the general entity builder, so we can edit all needed parameters from the step Edit Current option. For the static analysis, we specify the increment and the period and we press OK. Furthermore, from the Output Requests tab, we select the node output, define the U variable for displacement results, and we press Insert. Similarly, we enable the element output, define the S variable for stress results, and we press Insert. Prior to writing out the model, we can perform some checks related to the respective solver, so as to make sure that during the initialization of analysis, no errors occur. Execution of checks is done and our model is ready to run. We can now output the model as Abacus file and solve it. In this slide, we see the qualitative stress distribution in the welds region. So with the aid of Ritomo and Anza, we reverse engineered the structure and came from zero to a CA model that we can further analyze. In this scenario, We removed the real whales, replaced them with the ideal ones as proposed by ANZA, and compared the stress distribution in the whales region. Similarly, one could easily modify any component's design, for example using morphing functions available in ANZA, and reevaluate the performance of the component or the assembly. Additionally, if we had the ideal model of the shock absorber, we could add to it the real geometry of the welds from the CT scan, increasing this way the accuracy of the simulation by introducing manufacturing flaws. The CT scan that we were using until now was a relatively small one. However, Retomo is able to handle and process huge datasets as well. For example, a complete vehicle CT scan of low resolution can start from 30 GB. In this slide, we see how a complete vehicle scan looks like in Retomo. It is a mini convertible, and the level of detail is high enough to even estimate the age of the pallet wood. Then, by importing the mesh generated by Retomo into ANZA, we come to the point to apply the CAE science, such as the identification of deviations between the manufactured item and the CAD. Or, we can further process the CT model and separate the scanned structure into parts as they are in the CAD model. Moving on to Meta, the post-processor, we can export the CT images from Retomo and view them in Meta. Thus, take advantage of the Meta capabilities. In this example, we are viewing the CT scan of a crashed vehicle on the left, while on the right we see the virtual model of it. So we have the ability to compare a real crashed vehicle with its simulation. Furthermore, we can view our models in virtual reality, perform actions such as opening the hood, and inspect the internal structures. By loading the final step of the analysis, we can compare the simulation result with the real one and perform cutting planes for further inspection. Additionally, we can create annotations and mark locations on the model that we consider as critical to share them later with our colleagues. We can even enable the X-ray view mode, and we see the CT scan in the three-dimensional space. With this, we conclude this video. Thank you for watching.